So I would like to ask you a specific question because a lot has been spoken about this abrogation of Article 370. Till date, there is a lot of debate over it. What I understand from interacting with the rank and file of the Northern Command, that you are one person who believes in making an assessment on the ground. So today I'm asking you this question. Post abrogation of Article 370, you as an army commander, what do you think has really changed and how important perhaps this decision has been?
So post abrogation of Article 370, when the UT government came in, we are seeing a lot of initiatives being taken by the UT government in terms of development, in terms of good governance, in terms of addressing the grievances of the people. A lot of opportunities have been provided to the youth. And therefore, the youth and the awam are seeing, ushering a realization of government and security forces, giving a positive push toward development and peace initiatives. And like I said, the parents, have been instrumental in pushing a large number of surrenders. Therefore, the security forces, the civil administration, and the leaders of the society all have joined hands, in generating a human touch, which was much desired, by this misguided youth, and which is being, being done on the ground. So this is what we are seeing visibly on the ground since August 2019. And this is what is making the difference on the ground. We look forward to a lot of support from the awam, which is happening in a big way, and that is our biggest strength.